Well, it's a nice crowd apparently. Welcome, teachers and staff. Here's most of you. Nice to see you all. We will stand for the pledge.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
He says they can.
We will take comments from visitors.
Dear Rollinsford School Board, it is with great sadness and disappointment that we feel it necessary to respond in writing to your recent proposal. The purpose of this letter is to bring forth our concerns regarding the proposal and its impact on the relationship between the Rollinsford School Board and the Rollinsford Education Association. We acknowledge that you've made an effort to at least partially address the financial inequities that recent years have brought upon five professional staff members at Rollinsford Grade School by providing a one-time bonus. However, it's essential to note that as a board, you have the legal right to place teachers on their appropriate step based on years of experience by appropriating the funds into the general operating budget. This can be done legally without input or permission from the budget committee and or select board, and regardless of whether the contract is passed. In many other towns and school districts, teachers receive the appropriate steps regardless of whether the collective bargaining agreement passes. The one-time bonus that you've proposed is an incredibly small percentage of the amount that these individuals are entitled to based on their years of teaching experience. When you as a school board fail to grant steps to deserving employees, especially when there is an operating budget surplus of over $125,000, you are accepting and endorsing a gross injustice. The school board should commit itself to doing what is legal, just, and right by placing all employees on the correct step. Doing so will cost far less than what the school board overbudgeted for special education expenses. And there's a chart below that you can refer to these five involved individuals. When each of the above-mentioned staff members were hired, they were provided with a contract that outlined the pay structure. It is clearly written that for each year of experience gained, the financial compensation increases, as noted by steps in the pay scale. For the past several years, this has failed to occur. Longevity has been awarded based on years of experience, but steps have not. Why has the school board chosen to ignore repeal of the Evergreen Law when it calculates longevity, but not step placement? This money is not just a number on the line of a budget. This money to which each of these five professional staff members affected are entitled is money that pays for mortgages, daycare, student loans, and more. Without using your legal right to provide the appropriate pay for years of experience, you are withholding real things from real people, causing financial strain on real families. In addition, it's incredibly devaluing as professionals and belittling of the effort and experience that these five members of the professional staff have dedicated to Rollinsford Grade School. In writing this letter, we are appealing to you to make the ethical and legal decision to provide the appropriate financial compensation to each of the five professional staff members based on their years of experience. issue new contracts to those five employees, placing them on the appropriate steps, and show the community of Rollinsford, the staff of Rollinsford Grade School, and the students whose futures we together are shaping, that you will not allow this injustice to continue. We respectfully anticipate a response from you. Sincerely, the Rollinsford Education Association. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Together and give out awards for acting. then we also look for annual teacher barbecue, which for us this year is on June 20th. It's always the last day after finals. This way to thank the teachers for all that they've done and just having a nice lunch to eat. And we also were informed of new advisors for our student council next year. So after 7 years, Adam Durkee is doing it. It is now going to be Alicia Robleski and also Gail Griffiths continuing on. And a new thing that our student council has taken on this year is to help with eighth graders kind of establishing their class officers before they come up to high school, so that way they don't have to spend any time establishing all that. They already have those positions filled. Our National Honor Society has handed out our scholarships this year, so we handed out 5 to the following students: Mariah Wachowski, Holly Morris, Jeanette Morosi, Avery Kretschmar, and Jamie Croto. As far as our class councils go, the freshmen are just busy in a multitude of fundraisers. Our sophomores are selling t-shirts. They've had t-shirts all throughout the year they've been selling, and they're now doing their senior send-off sale, which is going really well for them. They also sold water and popcorn at graduation. They are planning multiple car washes, and they set their date and location for proms will be May 19th at the River Mill in Dover, which is really exciting to them. The junior class has planned 3 summer car washes as well. We are also doing Loudon in September. We are scoping out different senior banquet locations as well as project graduation ideas. Then a big congratulations are in order because our seniors actually graduated last night. And tomorrow night is their senior banquet at Spring Hill. So our sports are done for this year, but we had a meeting today regarding next year's ball sports. So we have a form handed out for that, which is nice. And then our guidance department is sponsoring a college boot camp to be held on August 21st and 23rd, in which we'll go over college essays, what to look for when you're going on college tours, when you're just researching colleges in general, how to fill out your applications, and then scholarships as well. So it's covering all the bases, which is a great tool for us. So, thank you.
Now, refresh my memory. You will be a senior next year?
Thanks.
And Noah, you will be a senior next year? Wow.
But it also means you both have studying to do, probably, finals coming up and all that. As usual, you are welcome to stay if you would like to, or you are excused if you have other things present that you need to do. Thank you both very much.
Never know what can happen in July, so instead of trying to gather everyone and allow that to happen, typically you've given the authority to the superintendent to do the hiring, and then I would certainly share that information with you if it happens in August. The person or the superintendent will share that information, not this superintendent.
All right, any questions or concerns from the board on that?
So if there's a circumstance arose and you need to
and then what
like
happens?
For example, you know, a teacher decides to leave in July. So Kate and the committee goes through and comes up with a candidate. I meet and interview the candidate. I can offer them the position, not saying it's tentative until the board meets in August, because they may get an offer elsewhere and take a job elsewhere. So it allows me to say, you're set, I can hire you. And then I'll just bring you the nomination form like I typically do when we're doing it.
Any other questions? All right, then a motion, please, to, I believe we need a motion on that.
Correct.
A motion to allow the superintendent to do some hiring.
I make a motion to allow the superintendent to do the hiring.
Second.
Second.
All right, any further discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye. Second action item is an update to the Rollinsford school calendar for 17-18.
Yeah, so
go ahead.
I'm sorry. So Kate and I have Kate spoke to me about possibly changing the in-service days to not always fall on a Friday, which affects their schedule and their specials in particular. So we look to move those dates around. So if the board is fine with that, then we will repost this on the website, get it back out to staff, because it's different than what's out there. We would do, you know, correct it in all the places that it exists.
Is it simply being moved to the Thursday before the Friday, or they're all moved around? I did not presume the calendar.
So they are moved around sometimes. So it could be a Thursday, it could be a Wednesday, it's a Tuesday. So we didn't try not to pick the same day.
Questions or concerns from the board?
No.
So the biggest piece will be, I will share this with the bus company, because they will now have a Rollinsford calendar, a Summersworth calendar, and a Marshall calendar. Mm-hmm. That all do different things. So they're the people I'm the most concerned about, but I'll get them out and I'll have conversations and make sure it's set. And I will also share with Connie to make sure she follows up with that in August.
But it was already different from the Marshall calendar.
It is.
Our service days were not the same as theirs anyway. So.
No. They followed the Summersworth schedule, the in-service days did. So now it'll be, you know, they'll just see buses all the time, possibly, or not. I don't know.
I see buses all the time.
They can manage it.
Yeah.
I guess.
Yeah.
Do we need, again, do we need to, I guess we do, we need to accept the change to the...
I make a motion to accept the change to the calendar.
All right, all in favor, please let us say aye.
Aye. Thank you.
All right, and the last action item on our list, last time, or perhaps it was, anyway, at our last meeting, we discussed that there would be a memorandum of understanding with the Marshwood billing, and basically what has changed is simply the frequency of billing. And I don't know if you had a chance to look at it. It was very simple. It simply says we will now bill monthly. And they'll say, they say for what when they will bill each month. And I believe it's like a month and a half later. So any questions, concerns, thoughts on that?
Do you need a motion on that?
Yeah. It's a change to the contract.
Well, I'll be three for three. I'll make a motion to change the bill to monthly.
And the motion is to accept the memorandum of understanding.
That's
I think it was. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 Is that effective at the beginning?
Next.
Next school year.
Yes.
Yes. Yep. It's mature.
Yes. Starting.
It's really
September. Or October 1st, they get the census. We get an update.
Okay. Next is the financial update on the budget. All right. Is there anything, any reports, anything to be? All right, any questions, concerns? I do have a couple. Comments, I think so. Concerns? All right. So, at one of our, at a number of our last meetings, we can all see that there's a balance at the moment of about $77,000. And at one of our meetings, we discussed wanting there to be about $100,000. So, there's a couple different things we could do to sort of ensure that there's going to be about 100,000. Actually, hearing this evening for the first time that our bonus offer is not being accepted, revenue does it. That puts us up at that 100,000. So there's that. One of the other options would have been to either to reduce the amount we put in the special ed reserve fund. If indeed we feel we wanted to continue to do that, to make, be a about $100,000.
Yeah, so because it was a warrant article, we're not going to be able to touch that.
Okay, because it was a warrant article, we can't, it says up to, so we can't even change it.
So it's worded the way you would.
All right, then that, there goes that idea. Can't do that. So, all right, so it is what it is essentially at this point. Okay, it is what it is, we'll see what it is at the end of the year when it comes down to that. Any other, anything else on the budget? All right.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
No,
go ahead.
Care upkeep of equipment. That's leveled out for the year. It's at zero now. It's just
estimated that
I apologize.
It's estimated that it's going to be expended. Yeah, there's a backup to be visible.
Yeah, I'm looking at it. I'm yeah,
materials.
Just jumping ahead on you.
And everything that's highlighted in yellow in the backup has been encumbered.
Okay.
Yes, yeah, essentially it still has almost $4,000 still encumbered. So the balance is zero.
This
is not the final budget. Right. Okay. Is it? Anyone else? Okay. Then we'll move on to new business. At this point in the proceedings, we're going to take a moment out and we're going to recognize someone. He will not be with us at our next meeting. So, just going to take a moment here. And we know, Jenny, that you didn't want any hoo-ha. Believe me, this is the least hoo-ha we can manage. Believe me, you are not going to. I'm going to say a few words, offer it up to for anyone else to say a few words as we get there. So, Jenny Mosca is an educator of the highest degree. She has state and national recognition as one of the 2006 Milken educators. And for those of you that don't know, one is recognized in every state in the union. The search committee that hired her 7 years ago cited her energy, enthusiasm, and leadership, all of which have proven out over the last 7 years. When I started working with Jenny 5 years ago, I knew I had a lot to learn. I am a skeptical student, seldom accepting things at face value, and often questioning even seasoned professionals. Jenny accepted the challenge, and I'm going to take just a moment longer to share some of what I've learned. A good superintendent emulates nature in that she abhors a bad. So a good superintendent will fill in the missing pieces, the black holes, by herself if needed. Aside from the incredible volume of administrative and educational responsibilities a superintendent must fulfill, she also must work with diverse and ever-changing boards. If a board is hands-off, she steps in to lead and ensures nothing gets missed. If a board is hands-on, she steps back and provides support. By any measure, Jenny Mosca is not just a good superintendent, she is a great one. She can aptly be called a force of nature. Thank you, Jenny, for always setting high standards for yourself, for SAU 56, and for the Rollinsford School District. Thank you for always putting students first, and thank you for making this board the best it can be. You will be missed.
Thank you very much.
Others?
I'm the only one here from there, so, but I'll tell you, yeah, I mean, you clearly have gone through a lot in this district, a lot in our shared districts. Never a dull moment. But I echo a lot of what Jenny said. You've had a lot on your plate. You put in countless hours into this job. Retirement is something more than earned it. And I guess we all can say, you know, yeah, absolutely, we're going to miss you. We are going to miss you, but at the same time, we want you to be able to enjoy your retirement. And I'm sure you're going to. You'll miss the cold weather. Thank you for everything you've done.
I'd like to echo both of what you said. But in addition, I really want to tell you how much I appreciate all your help. You know, for me, being new, you know, taking on this role, it's a little bit out of my comfort zone, and you really helped me a lot, which I just really educating me with all the procedural stuff.
As a parent in this town, thank you for all your time and your hard work and your energy and your love that you've given back to the town. We all appreciate it. And we really miss hearing your voice at
5:30.
Several times every week.
Thank you.
Well said.
Thank you.
And to help you enjoy at least your first month or two, perhaps that will come in handy while you're still here in New England.
Okay. Thank you very much.
On the board.
Thank you. Thanks. It's been an honor to be here. So thank you for the support and for being as supportive as you've been for 7 years. Tough job. So if you don't have board support, it's a very difficult job. So thank you for that. I appreciate it.
We will now get back to the regular scheduled program. And we'll get into old business. Community connections. And while we discuss that, one of the things, I think we have a couple different things to discuss there. One is sort of our making very official our goals from our workshop, and then how we're going to proceed from there on. And the other is, I think, the student survey, right? Those are two things here. Are there other things? So let's right now, why don't we just talk about our goals for the coming year and then what we came up out of our workshop with. We came up with three goals, and they came out in this order. Number one, to place the teachers on the appropriate salary step based on their qualifications and experience. That's our number one goal for the coming year. Our second goal is to communicate consistently and clearly with all stakeholders. And our third goal was to investigate ways to work more closely with other town boards and committees to pool resources, save time, and save money where possible. Erin, would you like to talk about sort of one of our first steps in sort of communicating?
Sure. So in an attempt to communicate more often and more consistently and more clearly to update our taxpayers and our townspeople and parents and students, all stakeholders, on how we're working towards achieving these goals, we decided to send out a monthly newsletter. Just something brief to sort of help people who can't make it to the meetings or have questions to really get a glimpse into what we're working on and what we're going to be working on, and frequently asked questions and things like that. So hopefully that will be helpful for spreading information, and we're also looking for feedback from the community in terms of what you'd like to see covered in that newsletter. So I think our first one will come out in June, and we'll talk a little bit about the goals that Judy just outlined. And provide a little bit more information about where we're going this year, just to kind of get things kicked off.
Anyone else want to make any comments? Okay. And when we say monthly newsletter, we mean like as close to monthly as possible. There may be, who knows what's going to happen, but the goal is to keep it moving. Some very good folks here on the board who've been working on it, so thank you for that. All right.
right, so, and then we have the survey results, which, do we want to discuss those? We did a survey of a number of people, Emily was part of it, and some other folks, a survey both of Rollinsford Grade School and of Marshwood students.
Yes.
In both cases. So, do you want to say a few things about it?
Sure. I think we've all got to look at the results, and I think overall, all surveys were very positive. Rollinsford Grade School, there was positive feedback from the survey, and, you know, it was evident for folks, you know, some of the comments about their, you know, weren't initially happy about the configurations. Some were happy that things were changing again. Others found that, you know, they were apprehensive at first, but realized they didn't have to worry after they experienced it. So, you know, reading through the comments, I didn't get to see whether some of the comments were one-off of a comment or multiple comments from the results of the survey presented. So I'd have to go back in and actually look, you know, to quantify exactly how many. But I think overall, looking at the information, the comments, and the reading, it was very positive.
Yeah, I also thought it was positive on both in both places. Positive for Walsh Grade School and positive at Marshwood. It was very positive. I think it's really pretty good for the second year of transition in Marshwood to have such really such positive feedback. There were a couple of one-off ones there.
They were,
but obviously sort of an outlier. But again, things to we take it all in. So. And see what we can do to work with it. So again, good work on the board getting that out, and you know, many, many thanks to the Rollinsford grade school staff for getting those kids ready to go up there and keeping them on their toes here.
And I assume that was shared. I assume to you as I talk about it here in public, and I'll share with what Emma Shepard did today.
Great. Are there any other community connections? Transportation.
I have one.
Wow, I think we went 2 months without discussing it, but yes, thank you.
All right. I can't have a meeting without a military. So you had asked me to contact Dr. Nash regarding the late bus for next year. So I was able to track down a cost. So it will be $31.98 per day for next year. And that would start on Monday, September 11th. 2017 and end on Thursday, June 7th, 2018 for a total of 135 days for a cost of $4,317.30.
It's almost like they knew we had $5,000 in the budget.
I think so.
Isn't it? Amazing. We've been told, and again, I'm not sure this has been shared widely, but we've been told that there are 5 to 10 Rollinsford riders on that bus. We were at an early meeting, and it's only going to grow next year, would be my assumption. So, again, this is our best financial option, essentially. So, do we need to do like a consensus kind of thing to carry on with it?
I'll get back to John Caverly tomorrow and say, I assume the board is fine with that. To plan on starting on September 11th.
Concerns, discussion? Okay. So I think
we had an exhaustion there, I think. It's always good to keep, on top. Keep on.
And it's gonna stay on, it's gonna stay on the agenda. We will keep discussing it. Hope we get more feedback from students and what always goes forward as well. So by consensus, yes, we'll go forward with that. Marshwood contract items, these are just things that we want to start keeping in mind. We still have a list. And you have that list somewhere.
So I have that list, and it sits in with the contract in my desk. I can either leave it with Connie, or maybe what I'll do, Julie, is type it up and give you a copy.
Send a copy to someone, and I can make sure it's with the contract as well.
Yep.
And as I think most of you know, it's because in another year, I think starting next year, we'll be negotiating the extension of that contract. So we're ready to do that.
And the last old business is the good start time at Marshwood. Last we knew, you were still waiting for.
Yeah, I have no updates this time.
I have a slight update, that late start. I was visiting relatives in Europe, and my cousin's daughter brought her 12-year-old son, and he was practicing his English. So I said, well, in the United States, we're starting to talk of, oh, and he was sleeping the first day, so we couldn't talk. It was like, you know, 10 o'clock in the morning. Because in the United States, they're talking about late starts. And he said, oh, yes, here too. He said, we've had to fill out surveys, we'll have to do all this. And of course, his father's sitting there going, the work that we can happen, they'll just stay up later. But anyway, it's, so obviously it's happening around the world. I thought it was very interesting.
But the statistics say that supposedly they don't just stay up later. That's what the studies.
Yes, and I thought it was interesting that they were surveying students. Anyway, that's my little anecdotal late start. All right, future meetings. By convention, we don't usually meet in July, so our next meeting is August 10th. And as many of you, of course, are parents of kids here and parents in the city, so you know all the things that are happening at Rollinsford Grade School. The one I'd like to make sure that the board is well aware of, and some of you may be attending as parents, is of course the sixth grade recognition at the American Legion on June 19th. You can bet that at least the two of you will be there.
Okay.
And I will be there as well. It's a lovely evening. They do a great job of recognizing and honoring those students. I'm going to get closing comments now from visitors, unless there's any. Closing comments from visitors.
Are the results of the survey that you chose?
Name and address.
Tamara Nijakowski, Silk Street, sorry. Are the results of the survey that you took about the school going to be made public? Like whatever you prepare for that, so that we can see.
We actually haven't talked about it, but I don't see. It was not. It was not meant to keep them private. So I guess we hadn't thought about how best to make them public. Well, so the answer is yes. I think they will be.
Can I also ask how many respondents you have?
In which school?
Grade 7.
For the grade school.
Better numbers of respondents.
I'm just curious about the enrollment, because I didn't hear a number.
Yeah, it's stable. It has not changed since last year. It's 156 in the grade school, and okay. It has not changed in Summersworth or in Marshwood. It's the same as.
Okay, thank you.
Celia? Celia Lady Wolf, Washington Street. I had a couple of questions that I'm not sure you could answer, but maybe take to the marshalling board next time you go there. But I know that there's a regional agreement for access to different programs that Marshwood doesn't offer, but I'm wondering about advanced higher ed classes, like college level classes. If they don't offer something, do they offer a college course somewhere? Like, if they don't offer German at the school, could you go take it at UNH or something like that?
Actually, we have a board member who has an idea, of an answer to that.
There are 18 courses offered. I mean, you have to apply for that or work that through the school administration. But I believe there are avenues for students.
Within the school, like if you exhaust all of them in the school, is there an option?
Tell you what, you think so, but one of the breaks at your answer, so we'll get an official answer.
I've had experience with that myself. On behalf of the rec committee, there was a question brought up that the school board had applied to have a shed put up at the school. I'm wondering if that was in process or where it was going so that the rec committee could be aware of that.
There will be a shed, and it will be built and paved.
So, I had asked last night, Dr. Kelly, because there's so many of you asked the questions, and I told everybody. So I said, as soon as you can, I know you hire the director, I'd be happy to sit down with the director and Brittany and talk about all those things, because I've given everybody the information, but there's so many we're trying to work together. I think it would just be easier to have like one point of person, like the point of contact maybe is on for you guys, because you're right, it will affect you guys, but we can do that. We knew we were trying to do it at the same time as with you, so you guys can not meet each other.
Yeah, thank you, Steve. We appreciate you working with them and one point person. Very good.
In regards to next year's bus routes, have they gone up yet? Are you still getting registrations? Or?
Yeah, the bus routes won't go up till August.
Okay. And they'll be up on the website.
Absolutely.
They'll be up on the SAU website. Mm-hmm. And I don't think we pick them up on the Ross Route Facebook.
We haven't,
but we did not. Yeah. And they didn't even report.
And then my last question is on the newsletter you're trying to get out as a board. How do you plan on disseminating it to the public?
Oh, it will be mailed. It will be mailed. It will be mailed to every household.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, are there any further closing comments by the public?
I just want to let the school board know, Tracy Laurie, 496 for Harris. Just wanted to let the school board and everybody know that we're not quite all done our sports in Southern North High School. We have a student that is going to New England's this Saturday for javelin. So went to the States, then went to the meet of champions, and now will be has placed fifth in the state for both division for 1, 2, and 3, and is going to New England's on Saturday. So we're not quite done all our spring track and field stuff.
Great. Any further closing comments by visitors? Any closing comments by the board? We do have non-public, so we'll be sticking around. For those of you that we won't see again, have a good summer. Catch you all back here. Motion to go.